Hello, what is up guys? CraftNet here. In today's video, we will be taking a look at the state of 3DS homebrew in 2021. The Nintendo 3DS is a bit of an old console, launching on February 26th, 2011, and initially it didn't sell well. But as the years went on, the console started to sell better partially due to games and partially due to homebrew. The original model had an ARM11 MP core-based CPU running at a clock speed of 266 MHz, and it was fairly decent for a handheld console at the time. It had a Pika 200 GPU running at 133 MHz and 128 MB of RAM for the GPU and CPU. The model I'll be testing, however, is the new 2DS XL, which has significantly upgraded specs. Finding specs for this model was slightly harder, but it seems to have an ARM11 MP core at 804 MHz and 256 MB of RAM for the GPU and CPU, though this may be inaccurate to what it actually has, so if I got anything wrong, please let me know. Also, I couldn't find GPU specs for whatever reason. No idea why, just nobody seems to have them. Anyways, onto the homebrew. There are lots of cool things you can do with a modded 3DS, such as play ports of old PC games or emulate older consoles. I'll be dedicating one half of this video to applications and ports, and the other half to emulation. So if you want to watch one half or the other, be sure to check the chapters. Sure, there are the typical ports like Doom and Quake, and even less common ports like Duke Nukem 3D, but there are a few ports that stand out. Smash hit PC game Half-Life, released in 1998 for Windows, has been ported to the 3DS system. Zash 3D is an overall decent port of Half-Life, and while there are frame drops from time to time, it is more than playable. Definitely a great way if you want to play Half-Life on the go. Legendary hit platformer Super Mario 64, released in 1996 for the Nintendo 64, has also been ported, with enhancements such as 60 FPS, anti-aliasing, and a minimap for the second screen. This is overall one of the best ways to play Super Mario 64 in 2021, and I'd personally recommend it over 3D All-Stars Super Mario 64 for playing on the go. Now what about emulation? Let me get RetroArch out of the way first. While there is a port for it for the 3DS, it's a pretty bad port and I strongly advise against using it. Anyways, all NES games will run at full speed using the excellent Virtua NES emulator. It is definitely what I'd recommend for all NES games. SNES also runs very well using the SNES 9X port for 3DS, and you can even play some Super FX chip games. However, some have glitches and are also just incompatible. Blarg SNES is also an option, however it has less config options, the UI is more clunky, and it is incompatible with all Super FX chip games. Recently, a revolution was made in the new 3DS homebrew scene when an N64 emulator was released. Just a few months before Daedalus X64 was ported to the 3DS, it was said to be impossible to run N64 on the 3DS. However, this fairly new N64 emulator for the 3DS runs games pretty well using a new 3DS spec system. Super Mario 64 runs at full speed almost all the time, and Mario Kart 64 runs full speed when using the PAL release. Unfortunately, you will just need to use the PAL release of some games to get full speed in some titles, but it's pretty impressive nonetheless. 3DS homebrew is growing every month, and I think with every breakthrough that happens, there are more and more reasons to mod your 3DS system. Now personally, do I think you should mod your 3DS in 2021? Yes, it's an excellent system for homebrew ports and emulators in 2021. And while something like a Switch might be better for emulation, the 3DS is way more portable. Hey, thanks for watching this video. You can like and subscribe if you want to, but it's really up to you. I've been CraftNet, and I'll see you in the next video.